So, greetings. Welcome to my talk about debug prop. So, my name is Johann Fischer. I am embedded system developer for Phytek, and my job is to design of development boards, radio modules, and also software components, drivers, and so. And one of my still active project is the design of the real board. And this is also the motivation for this project. So I will describe what a debug prop is and what we need to implement in Zephyr for it, and what I had done in to get it working in Zephyr. So what is the what is a debug prop? It's a bridge. It's a device which serves as a bridge from an interface like USB or Ethernet to a debug board of a microcontroller. And there are a few well-known debug props. For example, Sega J-Link or Sega J-Link OB. You can find this prop on, for example, on Nordic boards. ST-Link, also Kyle U-Link prop as external device, and at least, for example, Dublink based on-board debug props. So here is a board with on-board Dublink based debug prop. And on the top middle of the board, you can see the debug prop itself. It's based on Key20DX SoC from NXP. It's a very relatively small circuit. And the firmware here is based on the Dublink project. And next, what is the Dublink project? It's great open source project license under Apache license. It is well supported by OpenOCD, and it offers at least three interfaces. It is USB CDCSM for logging and, example, tracing for debug messages, or we use it also as shell in Zephyr. The next one is USB human interface device for debug channel. It is based on CMC step standard and USB mass storage device support for drag and drop programming. And also it offers a bootloader mode for updates over USB mass storage device. So we can update the debugger firmware itself. And there are a few drawbacks with the project itself. It's, we need a proprietary tools to build it, and it's only possible on Windows OS. There's a way to do it on Linux, but you still need an ARM compiler and license for it. And the code itself from CMCF step is not well abstracted, and it's more an example how to do it. But the CMC step itself is a vendor standard from ARM, and it describes how to access the Cora side components from or via USB. And but from USB view or from user view, what features provide a debug prop, for example. That the future what we use every day or for daily work is, also for example, for this, for Mac Flash or Mac Attach, Mac Debug Server, something like that. It is a human interface device and a CDCSM for debugging. And so human interface device provides a debug channel. And this channel can be used with every target. There is no vendor-dependent code involved in this communication. So that I can use the same probe to flash or to debug a Nordic SoC, NXP SoC, or SDA SoC. And this optional feature is USB mass storage device support for drag and drop programming. That's very handy for beginners. You don't need the deep knowledge about this build process or this flashing process. Just attach your board to USB and copy the firmware over. And in this case, there's a it depends on vendor. You can just don't change the probe and use it with another SoC, another target, because there's a flash algorithm on the debug probe. And there's also a project to build this algorithm, and it's always made for a specific target. So what is my motivation to build a debug proc with Sapphire Atos? It's should not force me or to use proprietary tools, and I'm the Fire developer. I use this operation system, so I would like to have 100% on the Fire Atos based development board. Yeah, I mean it's the second best operation system in the world, because the first one is Linux. Yeah. So we could also have different interfaces for the host. For example, we can use Ethernet or Bluetooth instead of USB. We could also implement a GDB server on the probe itself and connect it over Ethernet. And it should also possible to use different SWD drivers, for example, a faster one. And yeah, we know it's now, we have a few different, few other USB classes in the Sapphire, so we could, combine it with other human interface devices or Ethernet class, something else. So my approach was or is to use the IMSI step reference and adapt this debug channel to the Sapphire Atos. So what we need to implement in Sapphire, the first is the connection to the interface or to the target. So EastWD is the most used interface on ARM SoCs, what we use in Sapphire. So I limit my work to EastWD driver only. There is no GTEC support. And yeah, we need an EastWD API for the driver. We need a controller or handler which mediates between the host interface, like USB, and the driver itself. And it should not depend on the host interface. And at least we need a host interface itself, for example, over USB. In this case, it is over human interface device. And we already have CDCM support. But what we still need, there is a view in there is PR in review. It is a serial number. So use support for a serial number. And yeah. And of course the hardware. We need a hardware. And in the Dublin project calls it the hardware interface circuit, because that's built an interface to the target. And these circuits are very cost efficient, and they're always based on ARM, because it's for ARM SoCs, for ARM's targets. So there are a few IO compatible circuits, and the NXP boards or Freescale boards use Kinetis, K20 or K22 based host interface circuits. Atmel, the Nordic uses Atmel, and NXP use LPC. So the connection to target is usually over serial wire. It's two-line connection, and also UART for debug message and transit. Just a small notice that the host interface controller, the hardware interface controller on the real board cannot be used for development because of RAM boundary issue on Kinetis, and it's we do not have enough RAM for it. It's for CAD20, it's half of 16 key, so not that good. So it's a simplified circuit, and you can see that we need more GPIOs on the debug prop self to emulate this interface, because there is no native implementation for SWG in the controller itself that's used for debugging or for debug board. And but what is the DEP self? What does it mean? Debug access board. DEP is an implementation of ARM debug interface. And debug access port self consists of at least of two main blocks. It's a debug port that provides connection to the debugger, so everything in direction of to the debugger. And it provides an interface to the access port. And access port self provides access to debug resources. So, and there you will see there's few for example, if for is serial wire, the implementation of debug port is serial wire DP or is WDP. And this is simplified overview about the entire system. They're on the right side, you can see Zephyr developer using nice and free open source tools like GDB and PyOCD to access debug resources. And what I'm talking about, this project, it's just small part of this entire system. It's a debug prop. And it is connected over serial wire to the debug access port, and debug access port is a part of SoC, and it's connected to the target. And you can see this few like ROM table on debug register, system memory, access ports, debug ports. Maybe it's familiar to you, and if you call the PyOCD with verbose option, you will see how PyOCD explores the SoC to find all the debug resources. So what is serial wire and SWG protocol? Serial wire is the serial interface with a clock on bidirectional data signal. The sampling is on the rising edge of the clock, and a data line can be driven by the host and by the target. The transfer self consists of two or three phases. The first phase is packet request phase, octet, following by acknowledge phase, and if its response is okay, then by data phase. Here we can see two samples for write and read. The first one is write transfer. I don't know what this one. It's to access port. And the other one is the read of ID register from data board. And one thing with SWG protocol is that it's for entire transfer we need 46 clock periods. So it's not multiple of 8. So it's, we cannot use another, for example, we cannot use serial peripheral interface to emulate SWD. So it's, we need to implement it as a bit bank, for example. And also there, for example, there in for the so in the request phase, the line is driven by the probe, and the acknowledge phase is driven by the target, by debug access port or by DP. So we need always a cycle turnaround between the phases to switch the logic. For example, the in output pin to in pin, and this, the same after acknowledge if it's a write request. There are two responses possible, okay, wait, and fault. There is no explicit response for protocol error. The data line needs to be held high. There are pull-ups integrated in debug access port, or mostly in debug access port, and protocol error can be also detected. Then we have just all once in the acknowledge. The other thing, SWD can buffer access port writes. So if we write to access port, it doesn't mean it was successful. Also for OK acknowledge, we need to check it again. And for access port reads, it's always posted. So we need another access to access port to read the data. Or if it's buffered, then we can, if it's the last request, we can get it over read buffer from debug port. It's just few details that we need to know before we can implement controller and the driver itself. And yeah, the driver because there is no dedicated interface for WD, the driver needs to be implemented as BitBank driver. And it requires fast GPIO API or GPIO drivers in the system. But our API in ZFI is very slow. It cannot be used for that. And the workaround is to write direct to the GPIO registers and the BitBank driver itself. There's a work around also to detect the port, which port is used. And the logic of the driver itself follows the CMC step reference implementation. It's tested on NAF52 and then Kinetis 64. There are a few problems with the driver. That's the clock frequency cannot be set accurate. A few difference, also small difference. And it's the driver itself supports only the circuit based on and two three-state buffers. So API itself is experimental and tested only with the backend driver. But theoretically, it should be possible to change the driver and use another implementation, for example, in FPGA. About performance of the driver. So with the current implementation and NF52 CPU running at 64 megahertz, the maximum SWD is serial via clock is about 4 megahertz. But it's only reliable up to 3 megahertz because there's some problem with the higher frequency. There are few problems with how it's read back the signal state of data line. And it's plain C. There is few, there's a delay between setting of the edges, and it's implemented in inline assembler, but other things are just plain C, and it's, we can say it's portable, something like that. But it can be optimized with inline assembler, and most of the performance can be more performance can be achieved for the write transfer. I made it up to for the write transfer to make it be it possible with 8 CPU cycles using conditional execution on Cortex-M 4, and it is possible to get to clock frequency to 8 megahertz, but it's not, it doesn't mean that that this overall performance will be better. Yeah. There's some drawbacks because the assembler, inline assembler code is more or less understandable and mass portable. I will show just as example. This is writes 8 or 22 bits to a pin, and yeah, it's not really, I don't know, it's readable, but it needs just 8 clocks, so if someone get it shorter, I will give him a real board. So, the other part what we need is a DAP controller self. It is a handler between the host interface and the WD driver. Also this implementation follows same system preference implementation, and it expects a request buffer from the host interface and passes a response buffer back. It just forwards a simple request to the driver. There is no rocket science. And this implementation of the DAP controller should also be independent of the host interface. It's almost done. The problem is the registration and initialization of the DAP controller. The current state is that only SWD support is possible, and DAP index is not used. It's also not used in PyCity and DAP link. This is a reserved feature, so I understand that this would, should be possible to have different SOC, more than one SOC connected to a prop. And yeah, the implementation works well with PyCD and ARM debug interface 5. We can find on Nordic SOCs, on Freescale SOC, and I tested it also on Microchip SAM-D21. It's an overview about the entire implementation. The USB human interface device class, it's the implementation from the Sapphire or from USB stack. And in the middle, this DAP human interface device could be removed or changed or interchanged with Ethernet interface implementation or something else. For example, also shell, and in the future. The DAP controller or handler self uses MBOX and mempools. I think it's the only implementation of it in the subsystem. No one uses it. I don't know why. It's very, very handy. And yeah, there is a CW D driver with the pins. So the host packets structure, there are two important request types coming from the host interface, which has influence to the performance of the entire probe. One is the host may submit request packed in a block. That's also a block of request. And the other one is a request about a block of data, for example, for burst read or burst write to the target. And sorry. So the next part is the host interface via host interface device. It's very easy to implement because it uses a human interface device from Sapphire. It provides same system compatible interface and can be combined with other functions like CDC, SM, mass storage device, Ethernet, and anything else that we have in Sapphire. But it still needed a few more improvements like runtime registration, deregistration, and coexistence with another host interface, for example, DEP shell or interface via internet. So it should be something like hot plug fähig. So if you disconnect USB and connect Ethernet, it should still working or also allow to have a shell implementation. Interface performance via USB, also it's give the entire performance of entire system. And for few speed devices and endpoint size of 64 bytes, we can have 1,200 bytes per frame. And there are 1,000 frames per second for the full speed. But what the SWD provides or give on the performance is that default clock period is about 1 microsecond, and the one transfer of 32 bytes is takes about 60 microseconds. So the burst write of 64 bytes of a block something is about 1 millisecond. So there's a lot of what we can improve for that throughput. It's far below the possible USB full speed performance. And typical throughput is about 23 kilobytes kilobyte per second. It's not that good, but it's the same with like BioCD. It's not further. Few details about the tools for debugging that I used. SigRock and PulseView. It's open source tools for logic analyzer. And the tools, they have integrated SWD protocol decoder and also other decoders for the debug resources like ETM, ITM, and TPU. And the next steps I would like to do is to implement SWO support and debug access port host support in the Sapphire or alternative, maybe later alternative host interface over Ethernet. Few samples from logic analyzer. The first one on the top is from the DEP link with default clock of 1 gigahertz. And you can see there's a lot of jitter on the clock line because for the write transfer, the clock is about 800 megahertz, kilohertz, and it's dropped to the 600. And the other one is Sapphire based prop with default frequency with 1 megahertz, and it's a little better. But that's still not the clock the user sets. So it's for 1 megahertz, we have 960 or 900 kilohertz. And this is captured from the J-Link on the Freedom board. And it's much better than the Blink and Sapphire based. There's no jitter at all on the clock line. This is just overview about the file structure, source file structures, and yeah, questions. You mean that one? Why is the compiler not to be able to optimize it? Or the compiler is not that bad. So that's why I say the overall performance is unknown. But as a human, you know what you want to have on the clock line. You know the needs. Yeah. It's for the compiler. It's not possible to know. So it's, but I don't know if it's a will be better. How I say overall performance is just unknown. But I think it is possible to have it faster in inline assembler. But it's done. Yeah, not. That's not good for the people. I mean, it's not readable. It's. Okay. At the end of the slides, there are a few references to the implementation of the doublink self and its embedded hyperlinks and PDF, and also references to the tools and specs from ARM.